Adham Sharara. It still says ITTF president, soon to be ITTF chairman. Now, where I come from in England, the chairman is very much the person at the helm, the person doing the work. The president is an honorary position. Now, of course, ITTF chairman is going to be very different.
Yes, in England you have the opposite system actually, not just in England but also some countries that follow the English system. But for example, in corporations you have a chairman of the board and then you have a president CEO. It's the president CEO actually that's doing all the work on a daily to day basis, and the chairman of the board is the one who chairs the board meeting and the one that, let's say, advises the shareholders and so on. So this will be the role as far as ITTF is concerned. Really, I thought about it a lot. Instead of a president with a lot of experience and a lot of background just leaves the sport, it's good to keep that person, not necessarily me, but anybody else, to keep that person involved, but with a lesser capacity. So to focus on certain issues, focus on certain plans, certain objectives, and have a full focus on that, and not be involved in the day-to-day operations of the association or the federation. And in our case, that's how it's going to be. Mr. Thomas Weichert, who's currently the deputy president, he will assume the presidency on September the 1st. So he will be the day-to-day president, and he will represent the ITTF everywhere. He will be the image of the ITTF. And I will step aside, and I will chair the annual general meeting, something I enjoy doing and I like doing and I've been doing for a very long time. But at the same time, I will have three main responsibilities and focused on those three, at least for the first year. So I will be delivering the P5 plan, something that I have started, so I don't want to leave it in suspense. So I will see it through until the end of this year and then deliver it to the ITTF Executive Committee and to its president. And then it's up to them to decide how to implement it fully, partially, depending on the funding. The second thing that I would do is to review the Constitution. So you may help me with that because you've been involved in this for a long time. Because we've been putting this aside as not so important, but the time has come now where we have done so much patching to the Constitution that we even have in our own Constitution sometimes some contradictions because of many changes that happened over the last, I don't know, 30 years or so. So now we need to really rewrite it from scratch and bring it up to the modern times, let's say, because there's still a lot of things in there. For example, that you have to do some things by mail. Now we have email, Skype, and so on. So we really have to modify. And finally, the third thing is to really help the ITTF step up as far as marketing is concerned. So I've never felt I had enough time to do it. I did the best I could, but I think if I have enough time, then I can introduce to the ITTF some much bigger companies and try to find these companies that would like to be associated with the ITTF and its programs.
So when you're mentioning the marketing, of course, one of the innovations was TMS. You will still be continuing your association with TMS.
Yes, probably more as an advisor and basically trying to direct TMS to do more for ITTF, and together with the president we will be very much working together. So you know, now the relationship between TMS and ITTF has changed. TMS now is acting as an agent of the ITTF. So I would like to introduce to TMS and to ITTF some new companies, shoe companies for example, which are not involved in the ITTF at all. We're using shoes that are manufactured by table tennis manufacturers. So why not have the big companies like Nike, Adidas and so on develop table tennis shoes? And I never really had the time to do this kind of work. Now I could do it freely and then try to bring these companies to the ITTF through TMS.
Well, very interesting indeed. But I think when you become president or whatever role you take, you tend to learn and you take advice from those who've gone before. Now, of course, you came in at quite a difficult time. I mean, Mr. Su Yin-shen had assumed the presidency after, very sadly, after only about, I think, about a 4 or 5 month period, Lolo Hammarlund from Sweden had died. And before him, very sadly, Ishiro Ogimura had died. And we're now here in Tokyo. We're in Japan. I mean, this is where Ogimura made himself absolutely world famous. What could you learn from Mr. Ogimura? And what are your memories of him?
Well, actually, a lot of what he has done inspired me. First, as you know, the first president of the ITTF was president for 40 years, Mr. Ivor Montague. At that time, that's how it was. Presidents had very long terms. The second one was Mr. Evans. who had 20 years. So the third one, unfortunately, had only a few months. So it seemed to have been going in shorter and shorter. Happily, I've changed the trend. I hope that the next president now can stay even longer than me, more than 15 years. But I've learned from Mr. Ogimura that you have to look at the sport in a different way. And he was trying to modernize it. Unfortunately, he didn't have sufficient time. He passed away before he achieved all his objectives. But he asked me to help him, for example, to have a ranking which is done by computer. In his time, the ranking was done by hand, by a committee. And he asked me, because of my background, if I could help improve that. So he tried to improve also the look of the game. But he was just in the beginnings. When I came along, I thought that we have to change the ITTF from a traditional federation to a modern, advanced, and progressive federation. And I think I have created that bridge. Now the next president can continue in that direction.
Just to explain that, when I started with the ITTF, there were five of us in our office in St. Leonard's-on-Sea on the south coast of England. But you were officially elected, I believe, 1999 in Eindhoven. And now if we reflect on those years, it's now 2014. What for you have been the highlights?
Well, I had specific objectives. The first objective is to make the sport better as far as visibility is concerned. That I don't mean visibility like number of hours on TV and so on. That came later. But as far as how it looks on TV and how it looks to a spectator. And this took a long time because we have a lot of traditions that were difficult to change. But we have succeeded. You can see today, for example, we have the score integrated in the umpires table. Whereas before, the umpires always like to have this kind of manual score. So we have changed a lot. We have changed the colors. We've improved the color here as well. It may look a little dark here in the stadium, especially the floor, but when you watch on TV, it's really perfect. You can see the ball very clearly. The ball is bigger, the games are shorter. So trying to move with the times and make table tennis a better experience for the viewer and for the spectator. We still struggle, to be honest, to get spectators into the hall. Table tennis is one of those sports that people like to play. And they don't like to just sit down and watch. Yeah. But here today and yesterday and the day before, we've really been very inspired to see the number of people coming. Yesterday, basically, you couldn't find one seat in the house. It was completely packed. Of course, Japan is doing very well. So the Japanese spectators are responding and coming to watch them. So for me, this was the main thing, to change table tennis from a sport that is old-fashioned to a sport that can be seen as progressive.
Now, of course, the next time we come to a World Championships in some 12 months' time, maybe you'll be able to watch some table tennis. Now, I look at the meeting schedule, I look at your schedule. I mean, over the past 10, 12 World Championships, 15 World Championships, how much table tennis do you actually see?
I try to watch as much as possible. One of my conditions is to have a TV camera, a TV screen in my office. So I'm watching on the TV a lot. But coming here to watch live, yesterday I was trying to watch the match between Germany and Japan. And I was called out of the match, I believe, something like 15 times. So I would get into it, and then I'm called out because there's something to deal with. And then I would come back. As I'm getting back into it again, I'd have to leave. But in my office now, one of the conditions is to have always a screen, so I can watch on all the matches as they're going on. But to be honest, I hope that the next president changes a little bit the style. Here I had 87 meetings in a period, of 8 days, and that's not the record. I've had more than 90 meetings. Yes, I've had in some championships more than 90 meetings, because it's the one time that everybody from around the world are here, and this is their opportunity to meet with the president, and I don't like to deny them that. So even though the meetings are short, sometimes 15 minutes, 20 minutes, half an hour, but there's many of them, from early in the morning to late at night, plus of course all the functions that a president has at the world championships, just like this, you know.
Yes. Yeah, my apologies.
Yes. And also presentations and so on. But I will advise the next president to maybe do something a little bit different. Perhaps in the beginning of the championships, he can have a kind of a forum where many people come, ask him questions and so on. Because often what I realize is that in the 87 meetings, maybe half of the meetings, some of the questions are the same. Yes, so you're repeating the same thing. So it would maybe be ideal to have one or two forums during the championships and answer all the questions. And then those meetings that are really necessary because there's something to conclude, a contract to sign or so on, then they could still take place.
So introduce, in good British vocabulary, Prime Minister's question time?
Yes, or yes, something like that. Yeah.
It'll be interesting. Now, of course, one of the hot topics is table tennis, a top five sport. Now, it depends on which statistics we look at. I mean, we're pretty much there, and congratulations to yourself on the way we've progressed, especially with the Olympic Games. Now, what is the next step for table tennis?
Well, you know, this is the toughest part. It was, I don't say it was easy, but still, it didn't take much time. It took maybe 10 years to go from the fourth division as far as groupings with the Olympics, the International Olympic Committee, and now we are in the third group. That means that we are between 9 and 14 as far as grouping of international Olympic federations. I would say that we're somewhere in the middle, probably number 11, number 12. And to move from there to top 5, of course, is very, very difficult. It may take much longer than the first step. But to do it, we need to be very creative. So I've started this plan and the system called DBI, which is called Database Intelligence, where we're gathering now input from everybody, not just the experts, but everybody. Because sometimes you get an idea from somebody from outside table tennis, a spouse or a child or even somebody that has never been in the sport, but they see something that we don't see. So now we've opened it up. We started first with the experts in table tennis, about 50 of them. We asked them to provide input, and usually this input is relatively traditional, but some good ideas on how to go forward. And now we've opened it up. Here at the World Championships, we've asked everybody to contribute, and the third phase will be to ask even more peripheral people to contribute. That means spouses, people from other sports, those that are in marketing and business and so on, how they would see table tennis moving to the top five. We have the criteria, so that's actually, as far as Olympics are concerned, that's easy. We know where we are weak, we know where we are strong, and we need to maintain. And the plan would be according to that, to try and get us in every criteria in the top five. Because if you're in the top five in every criteria, then overall, you must be in the top five, mathematically speaking. Then as far as popular sport, table tennis at the moment, if you go to the internet and you Google most popular sports, you will find table tennis appearing all the time in the top 10, but never in the top 5. We're some 7th, 8th, 9th. In some studies we're 6th and so on, depending who's doing the study, depending where the survey is coming from, if they include China or if they don't include China. But what we want is also the sport as a whole, as far as popularity is concerned, to appear in the top 5. And to do that, we need to do much more work, much more promotional work, and we have started doing that already.
Well, looking at the attendance here in Japan and my time with the International Table Tennis Federation, it is a far different organisation, a far healthier organisation. That is principally due to one man, Adham Sharara.